Group is a collection of all operations which fulfills the essentially four conditions. The first condition was closure, second condition was identity, third condition was associativity, and last condition was inverse. In addition to that, if it fulfills commutativity, it is abelian group, and if it doesn't fulfill commutativity, then means commutativity is not a compulsory condition, then that such a group is called as non-abelian group, and many groups are the non-abelian. So with example, let us study this non-abelian group in detail with the help of multiplication table. C3V point group is the best example of non-abelian point group. Many examples are there, but it will be easy for us to derive that. Therefore, I am considering it. I like to mention the thing again about the abelian group. Commutativity should be fulfilled completely for all pairs of operation. In case of C3V point group, if you consider the multiplication between axis and axis or rotation and rotation, you will find commutativity is fulfilled. From that, we are not expected to conclude it is abelian group. Other multiplications also we have to try. And in case in any multiplication, any other pair, if we find product and reverse products are different, then we can say that group is non-abelian group. Out of the 36 operations, many operations are there where this product and reverse product is not equal. Let us see this in detail with respect to only few multiplications. Other multiplications we can describe by means of multiplication table. An example of C3V point group is ammonia.
I am considering bird view of the ammonia. Means imagine a pyramidal shape ammonia molecule, nitrogen and three hydrogens are there. Those, that pyramidal ammonia molecule is kept in the open ground, and the bird is flying and going to observe that the ammonia molecule. Then how the bird will feel? Bird will feel as if like it's like a steering. Nitrogen is at the center and three hydrogens are there at the end. If I imagine a circle, then it will feel like a steering with three bars inside. So let me consider it is a 1NH bond making 120 degree angle, other NH bond, and further 120 degree angle, a third NH bond. And vertical planes are there, those are passing through the NH bonds. A vertical plane passing through nitrogen and upper hydrogen, that's the first vertical plane, sigma. In anti-clockwise direction, from your point of view, of nitrogen and this hydrogen, this plane, I am considering as sigma dash. Means what I did, this is sigma, while moving from sigma to sigma dash, anti-clockwise direction I preferred. And this is sigma double dash. So three planes, sigma, sigma dash, and sigma double dash. And during rotation, two options are there, clockwise rotation and anti-clockwise rotation. I am following positive rotation. Which is positive rotation? Clockwise? No, anti-clockwise rotation is positive. So I'll rotate the molecule by anti-clockwise direction. Means if I rotate molecule by 120 degree, then this hydrogen will come to the position of this hydrogen after rotation of 120 degree. And in order to distinguish all operations, I need to consider one knot. With the help of that, all operations we can distinguish. Means if I take reflection through this vertical plane, then this knot will come to this position. If I rotate, then this knot will come. This is a plane, other plane, that's a sigma dash, knot will come to this position. If I perform reflection through, here's a knot. Reflection through this plane, that's a sigma dash, then this knot will come to this position. Here the other vertical plane is there, no, there's a sigma double dash, the below that knot will come. So you will understand clearly, pictorial presentations are given. With the help of that, let us understand multiplication table for C3V point group with an example of ammonia. It's our bird view of ammonia molecule. Nitrogen is at center, and at ends of those three bars, hydrogens are there. From middle nitrogen to upper hydrogen, a plane passing through that NH bond, the plane is sigma. If we move in anticlockwise direction, then middle nitrogen to left side hydrogen, the plane passing through that bond is sigma dash. If we move again in anticlockwise direction, then middle nitrogen to right side hydrogen, a plane passing through that NH bond is sigma double dash. Means while labeling the planes, I am moving in anticlockwise direction. Ammonia molecule has C3 axis. That C3 axis is perpendicular to our representation and it's passing through the central atom, that's a nitrogen. And whichever operations I need to perform by C3 axis, means C3-1 and C3-2, those will be in anti-clockwise direction. In order to distinguish all operations, here labeling nitrogen H1, H2, H3 is not needed. Only one knot. Where is it? See now. It is to left side of the upper nitrogen-hydrogen bond. With the help of that black knot, we can distinguish all operations. Maybe it is a rotation operation or reflection operation. If I rotate this molecule by say 120 degree, the anticlockwise direction, then that knot will come to lower side of left bar, left NH bond. Similarly, if I continue the rotation by further 120 degree, means total by 240 degree, then that knot will come to the upper side of sigma double dash. That's our imagination. Properly should able to work with it. If I perform the reflection operation through sigma, then the knot now is to left side, will come to right side. If I perform the reflection through sigma dash, then that knot will come below the right side bar. Means that's a sigma double. You are finding that bar. That's a NH bond. Below that bond. If I reflect through sigma double dash, then that knot will come near to left side bar, but where? Upside or downside? Right upside. C3-1 means rotation by 120 degree. After rotation of 120 degree, I want answer from you. The knot, whichever is to left side of the upper bar, upper NH bond, where will it come? It will come to the left bar. Yes, I agree, but where? Upside or downside? It is to the downside of the left side bar. After 120 degree rotation. Now I want to perform next reflection operation through a plane sigma. Molecule is rotated, but our planes will not rotate. Plane will remain as it is. What is our consideration about the sigma plane? Sigma plane is passing through central nitrogen and upper hydrogen, whatever may be the kind of rotation. I want to reflect the result obtained through a plane sigma. What do you think? After reflection, that knot will come to, of course, right side, but I want answer from you. It will come to bottom portion of the right side bar or upper portion of right side bar? Bottom portion of right side bar. So this is a result of sigma reflection. Or I can say extreme right side structure is a result of C3-1 as well as sigma, or C3-1 into sigma. Now I have to ask a question, whatever the resultant structure is there represented at right side, how can I get that resultant structure from original structure? Think on that. How can I obtain resultant right side structure from original structure? What's your answer? Right, that we can achieve by sigma dash operation on the original structure. What is the meaning of this representation? C3-1 into sigma is equal to sigma dash. What our multiplication table says, let us see. Here also C3-1 into sigma is equal to sigma dash. Yes, I am representing that multiplication. C3-1 into sigma is equal to sigma dash. In order to prove it is a non-abelian group, I want to try the reverse multiplication, sigma into C3-1. And what is expectation? The answer should be different than sigma dash. Let us see in detail multiplication of sigma and C3-1. Reflection through a plane passing through the upper bond. What do you think? That knot will come to which position? Yes, right side to that bar. So resultant structure will be with the knot at the right side of upper NH bond. Now to this resultant structure, I want to perform rotation operation. Let me perform first rotation operation. That's a C3-1 rotation by 120 degree. After rotating the obtained resultant structure by 120 degree, where will that knot come? Certainly it will come to left side, but where? To upper portion of left side bar or to the down portion of left side bar? Absolutely, it will be to the upside of left side bar. Now I have to ask a question. How can I obtain this resultant right side structure from original structure? In original structure, knot is towards the upper bar and to left side. And in resultant structure, knot is towards the left bar but is upside. Yes, what's your answer? Sigma double dash is a right answer. What the meaning of this diagram? Sigma into C31 is equal to sigma double dash. Let us see what our multiplication table says. We are right. Sigma into C31 is equal to sigma double dash. Let me represent this finding in mathematical way. Sigma into C31 is equal to sigma double dash. What was the multiplication of C31 and sigma? It was sigma dash. Now I am getting sigma double dash. So what can I say now? Product and reverse product both are not equal, means this group is non-abelian point group. Here I try to prove the multiplication between rotation and reflection. Other possibility is there, reflection and reflection, because rotation I said commutative is fulfilled. Rotation reflection that we tried, reflection rotation, after all it is equivalent to rotation and reflection. Now last portion left, reflection and reflection. So let us validate the non-abelianity of C3V with respect to reflection operations. After sigma operation, the dot which is to the left side will go to the right side. See the structure. On this structure, I have to perform the other reflection operation. And what is that reflection operation? Sigma dash. Now what will be the result? Yes, as a result, now the knot is to the upside of the right side bar. From original structure, how can I obtain this resultant structure? What's your answer? Yes, it's the result of C32 operation. Conclusion, sigma into sigma dash is equal to C32. Multiplication table also agrees with that. Sigma into sigma dash is equal to C32. On this molecule, I have to perform sigma dash operation, reflection operation. Afterwards, where will that knot go? Knot will come to the right side, but where? The lower portion of the right side bar. On this molecule, let me perform the other reflection operation, that is sigma, due to which where will knot shift? Knot will come to left side, but where? The bottom portion of left bar or upper portion? Bottom portion. Yes, now this resultant structure, how can I obtain from original structure? It is possible only and only because of C31 operation. So what's the conclusion? Sigma dash into sigma is equal to C31. Our multiplication table also reveals that sigma dash into sigma is equal to C31. With the help of mathematical expression, you can represent our findings as I did for the last multiplication and reverse multiplication. Here with the help of multiplication table, I represent sigma into sigma dash, answer is C32, and reverse product, sigma dash into sigma, answer is C31. Both are not matching. So commutativity law is fulfilled or not? Not. Therefore, the group will be abelian or non-abelian? Non-abelian. Only one multiplication was sufficient, but I wanted to prove the multiplication between rotation and reflection separately and reflection separately. Therefore, I considered this second example. It is true that C3V point group is a non-abelian group, but what is the specialty of non-abelian group? In non-abelian group, number of classes, are they equal to the order of the point group? No, point group has order 6 here, 6 operations are there, but number of classes are only 3, identity, a class of order 1, C3, class of order 2, and vertical planes, class of order 3. In case of C3 class, C31 and C32, these two operations, and in case of the vertical plane class, sigma, sigma dash, and sigma double dash, these vertical planes are there. Means whatever we have studied in the classes that we are going to understand in case of the non-abelian point group. At that time, I told you this clause. Again, I am adding here the specialty of non-abelian point group. Now see, homework for you. In abelian point group, commutativity exists for all pairs of operation.
in case of non-abelian point group, commutativity does not exist. Does this non-commutativity remain for all pairs of operations? What's your answer? Yes or no? Write that answer, yes or no, in comment box.
Yes, now we have covered 2.1 and 2.2. Important portion of syllabus. Syllabus is very easy, but I had given the in detailed discussion because in examination, you should not be in trouble to write the answers. When you will go through the questions, then you will understand. Therefore, the points were discussed in detail. Now, students, it is your turn to study them well and score good in the examination. But next part is an important part in order to learn these group theory and molecular symmetry properly. It's just a simple basic part it was, but it is important. Let us see the next part of representations.